Facebook mail today and thought to myself, I should go grab my camera before I open this. I did not go grab my camera, and I totally should have, because what was in the package was my very first physical ARC ever given, and it was me winning the Goodreads giveaway for Hummingbird Salamander, Jeff Vandermeer's new book coming out April 6th. It's probably already out at this point when I'm posting this. I should have recorded myself, because that would have been amazing to find out, because I had no idea I was getting this book, but I didn't. Anyways, I'm going to start this today. I also have Borne, which I need to read, so I decided, let's do a Vandermeer vlog where I read two Vandermeer books. Borne is sitting right next to me. I didn't even know it was there. So I'm going to read these two Jeff Vandermeer books, and I'm going to vlog my experience. I'll probably update you at the halfway mark for both of them. A halfway update and then a finished update. Just like a quick, you know, a quick update. So I know I said I was going to update at like the halfway mark, but I realized that this book has three parts, so I'm gonna do an update for each part. Part one, it's going good. I love Vandermeer's writing style. It is very like stream of consciousness type, like she's talking to us, and so it reads almost like journal entries or like a tape recording, and so she's not following normal thought patterns. It's just very interesting. It is difficult to read. I've actually had to turn off my music. I normally listen to like lo-fi or instrumental in the background, and it's actually preventing me from like comprehending everything, so I've had to turn my music off. This is definitely a slower pace than I was expecting. It's very character driven. Like, we are in Jane's head and we are learning about Jane, and we are all about Jane, and the mystery is there, but I would say that the predominant point of the story is not the mystery. It is Jane's character as she is going through this mystery. As far as I can tell, this is not weird. It's not sci-fi. There's not any speculative elements yet. So if you're expecting something similar to Annihilation as far as driving force behind the plot, that is not it so far. I could be surprised closer to the end. I do kind of hope that it starts to pick up in part two, just because while I am enjoying it, it is taking me a while to get through it, and I think it has a little bit to do with the slower pacing. The pacing is not bad, it's just slow, and I've been reading a lot of fast-paced stuff lately, so it's taken me a minute to kind of get back into it. That is my part one update. I will see you at part two. Thank you. stop setting expectations for what I'm going to update because I never follow them. I finished Hummingbird Salamander last night. I also just filmed my review for it, so that'll be up before this vlog will be, so you should go check that out if you want, like, very, very in-depth thoughts. I go through, like, all of the elements of what make this book great and not so great, but essentially I really enjoyed it, and I thought it was excellently well done. I spent, like, 10 minutes talking to my husband about it last night, and I definitely think if you love Vandermeer, you will love this book, unless you're only in it for, like, the weird, trippy stuff. The ending was incredibly satisfying, but also, like, abstract and doesn't give you all of the answers, which I loved, but it was still very satisfying. It obviously picked up the pace a little bit and got more action-packed. Section 2, part 2, is really the most action-filled part of the book, I would say, although part 3 has some as well. It's a really well-done thriller. His beautiful writing is just... it's just to die for. I just don't know what else to say about it. It's to die for. I love this author. I'm so thankful that I got to read this book. I feel like I'm not really giving you any really good information on this, but that's okay. Just go watch my review. I will be picking up Borne today and starting that, so I will update you at some point with it. I'm not going to tell you when because I don't want to lie to you. I hope y'all are having a good day. Just finished part 1 of Borne, and I love this already, whereas with Hummingbird Salamander, I was struggling with the pacing and just getting kind of confused of what was happening. Borne immediately sucked me in, and I love it. I love it already, and I can kind of see a direction of where I think it's going to go, and if it goes in that direction, I'll be very, very pleased, and if it goes in a different direction, I will be even more pleased because it didn't go in the direction I expected it to go. It does help that the main character's name is the same as mine. That always just makes me feel like I can connect to them more. And this is like a girl and her dog story, you know? It has those vibes of like becoming Winn-Dixie or whatever. That's what it's called, right? His personality is so adorable, and I have a feeling it's going to get darker as time goes on. I had a thought while reading this that I really want to see Vandermeer write like an actual romance novel because everything I've read of his has had like romantic undertones but not like a straight romance plot, but I feel like he'd be really good at it actually. He has a way of describing people's feelings and then people's not feelings, like the feelings they don't let themselves have. He has just a way of describing that so accurately, and I feel like him and Anne have to have such a great relationship that it would come out really well in a romance novel. So come on. If you have not read Borne, now that I am in through part 1, I can tell you that it is a dystopian novel set in the near future where pollution has kind of destroyed the planet, and that there is a company called The Company that does like biotech research, and they have created basically animals combined with technology in an attempt to circumvent the pollution of the world and provide services to people and themselves, really make money but survive the pollution. So for example, there are these beetles and worms that act as like health things. Like the worms go into your body and administer drugs and sew up wounds that need stitches, and the beetles can act as like communication devices or like drugs. I still don't understand it, but it's very biotech-y in like every sense of the word, biology and technology combined, which is a very unique premise. So if you're looking for a dystopian with a unique premise, Here you go. We are following Rachel. She is a female. Obviously, she is in a relationship with a guy named Wick, but this is a dystopian, so we don't really focus too much on a relationship. We're just kind of surviving together. You know, we don't want to kill each other. We're living in the same place. We're having a relationship. But there's more to it because how they both grew up in the pre-world, you know, so they know about relationships and feelings and things from that pre-world. But now in the post-world, they don't really know how that connects to their real life, their real day-to-day survival life. Anyways, Borne is adorable. Rachel is, like, kind of lovable, but also mysterious. Like, he has this thing about mysterious characters. I also am not annoyed with how he's writing this female character. Again, every time, I'm just very okay with it. And I need to do, like, a video on why I like his female characters so well. Really excited to see where it goes. I'm only 50 pages in and I'm enjoying myself so much, so stick around to find out more information. It's taking me a really long time to get through this book just because I've been trying to read it during the week, and so it's been slow going. Part two ended differently than I thought it would. The kind of climactic moment of separation came in a really weird way from what I was expecting, and so I'm like really curious what part three is going to look like. I'm hoping it gets like a little bit bigger scope than it currently is. Like right now it's been very small scope, just focusing on the relationships between the three characters. So I really want kind of like a broader scope moment in part three. So hopefully that will happen. I feel like I can't quite gather my thoughts for how I feel about this book just because I've been reading it so disjointedly. I've been reading it like 50 pages at a time, 30 pages at a time. So I don't really have a good grasp on how I'm feeling. I know I like it and I probably would be enjoying it more if I had been able to read it in like a couple of sittings instead of several sittings. I'll let you know how it ends though, how I feel about it at the end. So I finished Borne about a week ago and never actually recorded any thoughts or final updates, so that's what I'm doing today. This book definitely went in a direction that I was not expecting, and it turned out to be, I made a joke at the beginning of the vlog about Jeff Vandermeer needs to write just like a general romance book, and this was almost that. I still have lots of questions about this world. I can't wait to read the sequel. I am hoping that it gives me more answers than this book did. And if I look at this as the start to a series or at least a duology instead of just a standalone, I'm much more comfortable with the ending because it did not end in a very satisfactory way, but I enjoyed kind of like the surprise of where the book ended. I was not really expecting that. Although I also wasn't surprised, like it made sense in a way. But again, I'm just curious to see what happens and where things go. I did struggle reading this book. It took me a long time, a lot longer than I expected it would. And I don't know if that's just because I was trying to read it during a work week instead of like a weekend. But even on the weekends, like I was only reading 50, maybe 75 pages at a time. So it took me a while to get through, but I really liked it. I don't know if it would take Annihilation or really Authority out of line as my favorite. There wasn't as many of the horror elements that I enjoy, the specific type of horror that I enjoy in this book. There was some horror, but it was a little bit different than what I typically enjoy. I don't know. I guess those are my final thoughts now to just wrap up the vlog in general. I read 2 Jeff Vandermeer books in a row, and I'm still pretty solid in my assessment that he is one of my favorite authors. I was expecting there to be a bit more consistency throughout his works as far as specific elements. I expected some specific elements to come over a lot more frequently than they have, but he is very consistent in theming and writing style and execution and character depth and character growth. I want to read another book from a male perspective from him because I've only really read, besides Authority and some Acceptance, most of his main characters are from the female perspective. So I'm really curious to see more of what he does with the male perspective. But again, in this book, I had no issues with the way he was writing his female characters, and that is like high praise. I know Jeff Vandermeer has like a lot more stuff that he's done, so if you have a suggestion of where I should go next, like after I read Dead Astronauts, of course, because that's the sequel to Borne, but where I should go next as far as making my way through his canon, let me know, because I'm not really sure which direction I want to lean into. If you have, I've missed some of the horror elements from the Southern Reach trilogy. I want some of that back, so if there is something else that he's written that has more of that horror element, send it my way. Thank you so much for watching this vlog. If you have not read any Jeff Vandermeer, I hope this convinced you to go pick up one of his books. He is one of my favorite authors of all time. I love what he does with character and with world and story. So if you are looking for something like that, he's definitely worth your time. I post videos every Wednesday and Saturday. At least I try to. If you guys like the way that I talk about the books that I'm reading, make sure you subscribe so you can find out what I'm reading next. I hope you are enjoying whatever you're reading this week, and thank you so much for watching. I will see you in the next video.